You asked, I listened. So what I have here, the Funny Playing GBASP screen. No, I'm kidding. I was totally gonna make a video on this regardless of you guys asking. But I'm actually not gonna do that right now. I got something else planned. Something that I think is gonna be a little bit more fun for me, even if that's what you want. So I recently went to Washington on vacation with my family. It's a lot of fun. We went to a bunch of different places, but at one point I ended up in this toy store, the Magic Mouse and Toys. It's right in the middle of Pioneer Square in Seattle. I thought it was really cool, and I'm a grown-ass adult. I had to buy this, and I think I'm gonna go ahead and try making that. This isn't my first like Metal Earth model thing. This is just definitely the first time I filmed it. I did pick up one of these rovers here, and I built this a while back. This is unfortunately a bootleg because at the time I didn't really, I don't know, I was a different person then. But either way, this thing was a lot of fun building, so I think I can have a lot of fun building a new one. I like space stuff. Space stuff is cool, but this is one of their older models here. Take a look at the back here. Fun fact, these are actually made in Seattle, or at least that's where the company that makes these is headquartered. I'm guessing they're actually made in China based on the fact there are bootlegs that look pretty much the same. I don't even know how to open this stupid thing. There's like no seams. Oh, there's one. Anyway. So that's all that comes in the box there. You got the two sheets metal here. And please forgive me if this video turns out horrible because of how reflective these things are. But I think we can make it work. All the parts are numbered. This actually seems like something that I would prefer to build at my other desk, which has a little bit more room for the instructions here. Doesn't look too bad though. Just take it step by step and go from there. Oh, this is gonna be awful. Okay. So they had a lot of newer models there. I ended up going with the older one because I don't know. I like space stuff. I can't help it. Okay. So I think if I recall correctly, they were selling like flush cutters or something to help you with this. I already have flush cutters, so what the hell. But anyway, the store had a lot of the newer models. It's pretty cool stuff. Some Game of Thrones stuff, Avengers. Actually, really like their. They had like some weapons and armor, like old Samurai stuff, Wild West stuff. Really cool. The newer models there, some of them have some color to them. Excuse me, I'm gonna get some water. Holy cow. Okay, sorry about that. The way these are numbered are in the order that you use them. But I kind of wish they were numbered on here as well. Just so it's easier to find them. Oops, I accidentally bent that. No, but I think that's what we have to do anyway. These things are next to impossible to build without at least a good set of needle nose pliers. But I'm gonna try with my tweezers. So while we were in Seattle, family and I went on a underground tour. Lots of interesting history behind Seattle that I didn't even know I wanted to know. Just so happened that we ended up in the toy store after the tour, and gentlemen who worked there was telling me some interesting things about the toy store. Like when the original owner had purchased the lot and was cleaning up the property, renovating, they had found in the basement a speakeasy. I just thought it was, I don't know, not a whole lot to that story, but I just thought it was somewhat humorous that there's a, there used to be at least, a speakeasy in this big old toy store. Then we need part three. And, you know, it was walled off. It was blocked off, of course, because the speakeasy itself was from, God, I don't know. But either way, this was back in the 70s that they were renovating. And because it was all walled off and blocked off, I guess it was like a Prohibition era speakeasy. So the entrance was blocked off and everything. Had no idea it was there until they knocked a hole in the wall and found it. But, just tell me how the entrance to the toy store that I guess they don't use that much anymore. At least it wasn't, it was blocked off when I tried to go. Because this is multi-level, they've got two stories. It was the original steps, original entrance to the speakeasy. I don't know if that's just like tourist bait or whatever, but either way, I thought it was pretty fascinating. Really cool toy store, too. Not a lot of stuff for grown-up children, but. Or I think they had it worded children over the age of 25. But there's still some really cool stuff there. Oh, wait, I should have left that on the inside. Oh, well. It's not going to be perfect. Next, I need part number four. Which is this funny looking thing. And yeah, this is so much easier with flush cutters. Okay. Oh shoot, I bent that the wrong way. Hopefully, I don't break these tabs off. Think we're good. Trying to walk that down, but it's not going in. Oh, damn it. I'm on the first panel and I'm struggling. Not a lot of hope for me, huh? There we go. It's loose. It's gonna jiggle around. I hope that's okay. This looks, I don't like that. I should have bent those the other way. There we go. Not perfect, but better. And then looks like this gets twisted or something. There we go. Yeah. That way. These get bent down. Okay, I thought it looked funny. I already fucked up. I got one part in and I fucked it up. But that's okay. We can fix it. I put this top part on upside down. I was looking at the cover and thought, well, gee, mine looks kind of funny, doesn't it? But really, I was looking at that and I thought the illustration looked kind of strange compared to what I had. But it's okay. It's the first one I've made in quite a while. Only my second one ever. But this is why having needle nose pliers is very helpful, because none of these are gripping that tab. These tweezers don't quite have the leverage they need. You can pull it out anyway. Yeah. It's the right part and it's in the right spot. It's just upside down. Should go on the inside here. So I'm going to push these tabs down without scratching up the metal. It isn't perfect, but it's good enough. Because I accidentally scratched it right there. Okay. Now, still on the first panel. I think these just get bent down. Like that, more or less. Probably less. Okay. Now I need part number 5, which is on this sheet still. It's this funny looking thing here. See, I don't know how to bend those tabs. I'm gonna unbend that a little. Maybe I can get them started. The tweezers. Very close to buying, instead of this LEM, I bought a, or almost bought, a P51 Mustang. That was one of the newer models. But I figure, despite being missions to entirely different celestial bodies, the LEM would look a lot better on my desk next to a Spirit Rover. See, what's weird is this box wants to bend instead of the tab. I'm having a really hard time with this. Maybe if I stick that in the, oh. There we go. Oh, no, I didn't do it at all. Shoot, this is difficult. What can I use to squash both these simultaneously? That's not working. I'm just gonna hurt myself if I keep that up. I feel like I'm gonna break this thing before I even get these tabs squished down. Let me try it this way. Ooh, that worked a lot better. Should have tried that from the start. Okay. There we go. I only bent it a little. Okay, I don't know what this symbol means. Looks like bends that way. And that way? I hope so. Okay. Well, next I need part number 6, which is this big one up here. Think that's right. I'm guessing that goes in there. Yep. That needs to bend enough so that those connect. Same thing over here. just seems bizarre. Those need to come out more. That needs to be. Turns out we only have about 15 minutes, not 20 minutes, before the camera decides to cut off. Anyway, I just put that onto the main piece there. Didn't finish attaching all the tabs. There we go. Got all the tabs attached now and bent down. So that was right there. Now we need. Oh, that's what the E means. The E means the engraved side. Okay. So next we need two part number sevens. You'd think they'd be part number seven and part number eight. But okay. Especially since there's three of them. Oh, duh. It says right there, that's why I was having so much trouble. The green is twist 90 degrees, so you spin it instead of folding it over. Oh, brain dead motherfucker. Read the instructions. Okay. So that's. Oh, okay. I see what's going on here. Basically, we're twisting these into little cones, and then folding them up. Tweezers are very unsatisfactory for this work. But I think that's the best we're gonna get. For now. That one came out better. So while we were in Washington, my family, we checked out Olympic National Park, just a small part of it, because holy crap, is that place huge! Unfortunately, we didn't get to go on too big a hike through the park, but that's okay. Still got to see some pretty cool stuff. Got to spend some time with my nieces. We drove through down Highway 101, I think it was, which takes you right up against Lake Crescent. And holy crap, is that a wonderful drive in the mid-afternoon? I don't know why I was bending those up. I think I don't know why I was bending those up. I brought this camera here, which is not a camera, it's a smartphone, but it has a camera. Took some awesome pictures. It says just to twist that 90 degrees, so let's try that instead of trying to fold these stupid tabs over. That's not working at all. Think I'm more likely to bend the tweezers than bend these tabs. Oh, there we go. I gotta say though, the more people you travel with, the longer it takes to do anything. Oh my God. Just bathroom trips alone. But Washington really is a beautiful state. After Lake Crescent, we drove up to Forks. That's where we spent the night. If you've never been to Forks, it is it's pretty much a drive-through town. Not very big at all. And did you know that's where they film Twilight? Well, if you didn't and you go to Forks, they'll be sure to let you know because it's on almost every single building and at least half of the merchandise that they sell. I mean, it's a pretty beautiful town, though. As long as you don't mind the wet and the fog. But it's kind of sad that Twilight is basically their whole identity there. That one went a lot smoother. Seriously, though, if I'm in Washington again, I certainly would not mind spending the night in Forks again. Very nice town. Just a little bit weird with all the twilight everything. Course, I had to pick up some Twilight merch, or some Forks merch, excuse me. I don't have Twilight merch. Though at this point, they're nearly the same thing. Okay. That's that. I don't know why this one is so crooked. Drop the shit. All right. Flip this over a bunch of times. What do I need? Part 8. Part 9. Part 8 is right here. Roll this part up, I guess. Think last time I did this, I ended up using like a pen or something to give me something nice and flat to roll it on. Don't think my flex thing is quite thin enough. Of course, that's too much of an angle. That's okay. And this goes. Sure. I got parts 10 and 11 here. Go, what? Right there? That's kind of, oh, I guess so. Okay. Be part 12 and 13 and 14. So after forks, or before forks, I don't know, sometime during the vacation there, we ended up heading to a place called Ruby Beach. And does that really fold that way? That's kind of weird. Seems backwards. I bet it goes like that. And, Ruby Beach is very, very beautiful beach. To hang out there, not too long. I feel like I'm messing this entire thing up. See all the tree boons. Absolutely astounding how many, like, just dead trees were lined up along the beach edge. Hard to talk while I'm thinking about this at the same time. Pretty sure it goes like this because this looks great. Anyway, this amazingly, amazingly big rock on the beach. And then this, you can climb on. Probably shouldn't climb on, but like that stops anyone. And, this big, like, island part, a little bit ways down the beach. I wanted to check out, but unfortunately the tide was coming in and didn't really want to go swimming to get there. Right, I think that's right. I've never seen, I mean, like, I've been to the Pacific Ocean, California, never been basically Pacific Northwest, never seen the ocean up there, and I don't know, did some kind of freaky things, which is not quite what I was used to. There was a part where, like, it seemed the water was perpetually draining from the beach into the ocean. And, I don't know, it might have just been the area that we were in particular. It was just pretty cool, because there were, like, spots that were bubbling up, and you could, like, drop a rock on the sand and it would just sink in. I don't know. It was pretty cool. All right. Can't get too distracted. Next, we need more of part 7. I know what that is. I don't even have to look. That's this thing right here. And I thought I saw another one. There it is. But we also need part 15, and I bet that's this right here. There should be another one somewhere. Because it says I need two. Uh-oh. Oh, the other one's on the other sheet. Okay. It's right here. All right. Do part 15 first. Hopefully this isn't backwards. It looks kind of backwards. This is that part. No, I think that's going to be fine. I don't know how they expect you to actually bend that, though. Where are my... That wasn't too bad. Anyway, beautiful beach. Surprisingly, a ton of rocks. I don't know why that's surprising, but it is. Shut up, I've never been there before last weekend. And, unfortunately, I didn't find any cool things to bring back aside from a cool looking rock. But we weren't there too long and it didn't look too hard. Not to say there wasn't stuff, just that I didn't find anything. And there we ended up going to Ho Rainforest. We didn't really spend too much time walking around, like I was saying earlier. Just too many people, too many young kids. But that place is beautiful, man. Really glad I got to go. I'd love to go again sometime. Maybe when my nieces are a little bit older. Unfortunately, taking a 3-year-old and a 6-year-old on a trail means the trail has to be pretty short. Okay. One more. After that, we ended up driving up to Olympia. Spent the night there. Really, I think we did more driving around than anything else, but to be honest, I'm not bitter about that at all. Washington is a beautiful state, and the highways are just fantastic, very scenic. Didn't do too much in Olympia, though. Really just spent the night there until we moved on in the morning. We finally went back to Seattle. And that's where we did some tours, wandered around downtown Pioneer Square area. And that's how I ended up at that toy shop. And I think that brought me back to where we began. Despite being in the immediate area, we did not go to the Space Needle. We drove by it. That was about it. It's entirely too damn expensive. After literally just paying to park downtown all day, I don't really feel like paying to park again to go to the Space Needle. And it was too late in the evening to really do anything else anyway. So it's not like we could have checked out the museums in the area. But it's okay. It was still a lot of fun. Part number three, I believe, is this thing right here. This thing here. This goes on to this part. Destroying my nails by pushing down on these tabs. We're getting there. getting to the point where there aren't that many parts left. The ones that are left are getting pretty big. Now, I'm curious, can't even speak. Curious about how they design these things. It's kind of fascinating how everything lines up, but it's still flat. Flat thing. Man, I don't even know how I'm supposed to bend those tabs. It's giving me a green arrow, which means they're probably supposed to be twisted. But I don't think that's happening. That is tight, man. Think I'm about to get cut off here. Indeed, I did get cut off, but I think I got to a point where, continue anyway. Anyway, I got parts 17 and 18 here. pause that before I keep going. I think I need to bend these tabs a little bit down. I apologize, I don't know why I'm talking so quietly. I guess it's just been a quiet video. Haven't been talking too much. I don't know, guess I thought I had more to say than I really did. Noise. Okay. Seems odd. Quite fit how I expected. Or at all, really. Yeah, it does. I'm just bitching and moaning. Okay. Nineteen. Looks like that part. Yeah. Kind of difficult to figure out which way the folds are supposed to go in some of these. parts. Freaking up these thrusters. Okay. Again, I have no idea how we're supposed to twist those. So I feel like this part should go in first for these side pieces. Alright, well, that didn't go nearly as poorly as I expected. That was that. Now we need 20 and 21. Which, that is 20. And this here, 21. Oops. No, it's not. What the hell am I doing? Oh, yeah, it is. It's down like that. Asymmetric parts are funky. All right. I skipped a few steps because I didn't realize the camera had stopped. My apologies. Instead of trying to twist those, they're in a good spot to fold over, so that's what I'm gonna do. No, except that one. That one I should have twisted. Six. Okay. We need a big piece, probably on here. Oh, just kidding. Duh. We need this piece. Wait, we should attach those parts first, shouldn't we? Looks like 23. So it occurred to me a little while ago, while I was working on this here, I could probably make bootlegs of these things if I wanted to. I imagine this is just engraved and cut in a big ass laser cutter. I mean, not that I'm going to. Just really thinking about the process of how these are made. Because I'm weird like that. I went to my local makerspace last night. And let me just say, I regret not doing that earlier. I don't know why I put it off so long. But that place is amazing. I'm going to put this tab on the inside because that makes more sense. If you guys have a makerspace in your area, I highly recommend checking one out, checking it out. Lots of cool folks there, lots of cool tools. Things, etc. If you don't know if you have a makerspace nearby, then I implore you to find out. For your own sake, really. But I checked it out last night. They have. My local makerspace, anyway. Big ass laser cutter. A Trotec Speedy 300. Basically, the rule is, if you don't know what you're doing, have someone who does help you out. Use what you need. Leave what you can. Otherwise, go nuts. Have fun. Don't break anything. Don't hurt anyone. And, man, do I want to. I want to make some stuff. I mean, there are so many projects that I just haven't done because I didn't have the facilities or the tools or whatever. But I just checked this place out last night and, well, all that's going to change because they have facilities, they have tools. And they have lots of friendly people there. And presumably some not so friendly people, but I didn't run into any of those last night. But when I, after I, you know, after I get tired of the laser cutter, I can move on to the CNC router, the Bridgeport milling machine, the metal lathe. Get in there. What step are we even on? Oh, okay. And oh my goodness, I'm so excited. Like, for starters, that keyboard project that I mentioned, that some of you know more about than others, I had planned on using a stainless steel plate for that keyboard, but as it turns out, it doesn't work with the stabilizers I have, so I have to get a custom plate cut. Well, there is zero reason why I cannot just stick a sheet of aluminum in that laser cutter and cut out a new plate. Well, I'm sure there's actually plenty of reason why I can't, but I can, so I will. I'm going to, and it's going to be great. I just got to get a design that works, that I can actually get cut out. It's not my first rodeo as far as laser cutting goes, just the first time I've ever been this involved in the process, I guess. I've had stuff laser cut before. I used a company called Ponoco, I don't know. And basically, how that works is you send in a SVG and they send you either acrylic or wood or whatever. And there you go. But on this end, you know, I make the SVG, I put it in the program, I choose my settings, etc., etc. I'm just super stoked. Because if I had a big enough piece of acrylic, I could go get that finished today. Engraved side faces up. Or, well, tonight rather. But I don't want to be that guy who just shows up on his first day and uses all the materials. So I plan on ordering. I'll probably actually get it cut in acrylic instead of aluminum. Goes like that. Think that's right. I don't know. But the reason I'm thinking of using acrylic over aluminum is A, it's a lot cheaper, and B, I can get some really cool colors. But also, because they're a little bit short on acrylic, and I certainly don't need the whole sheet, so I figure, you know, if I order some, I can leave my extra. And that way, it's a net positive. It's so bizarre how this works. Okay. That doesn't fit though. What the frick? Maybe this way. Oh, but this is keyed, so it only goes the one way. Clever, but. I don't know how that's supposed to work. The clearance is a lot different in the picture than in reality. Let me fold those down a little, I guess. Wonder if I fucked up or what happened. But anyway, makerspace. Find one. Go. Have fun. Make stuff. Meet cool people. They have a lot of 3D printers too, but I don't so much care about that because I already have a 3D printer. I mean, I suppose if I needed to print out a bunch of shit in no time flat, I could enlist their aid. How in the heck? Supposed to go. Probably gonna have to take another break here pretty soon because 4K. Okay. As I was saying before I was so rudely interrupted, I was just complaining about how 4K is apparently more demanding on this phone. And it, I don't know, it must have interpreted what I was saying and didn't like what I had to say about it. That's okay. This video is getting very long, so thank you if you're still here with me. If not, I get that too. But if you're not still here with me, then I can say whatever I want. I can talk about you behind your back and you wouldn't even know it. Not believe the shit I talk about people behind their back when they tune out of my videos. No, I'm kidding. What? Interesting. Interesting. Okay. This. This is backwards, but it's too late for that. It's okay, you can hardly tell. See, this one doesn't say. Gonna go with my gut here. Do it the same as the other ones. Folded that way too tight. Oh well. Loosen it up in a sec. I'll stretch. I'm guessing those middle parts aren't supposed to be in there. Certainly hope not. We're in the final stretch here. Hopefully. Yes, I know. Hopefully, we can get through this without incident. Actually, hopefully, we can get through this without any more cuts. Quite frankly, I thought this was going to take a lot less time than it is. I didn't really plan for this. can bend that down without bending anything else. I guess just hope for the best and see what happens. There we go. Again, sorry with the whispering. I don't know why I'm doing it. My cat's being louder than I am. Oops. That is a wonderfully shaped octagon. Don't worry, I'll fix it. There we go. That goes on to here. Where's this part? I don't see this part on here. Oh. There it is. Just kidding. I was just testing you, that's all. Nice. need four of these little bow tie looking things. That's one. Two, three, and four. But where do these go? Oh. Up here. Is to twist them. But it's so much easier to just fold those in that situation. Yes, buddy. How's that so? Huh? Cat just got up from his nap. He's usually very talkative when he does so. Okay. Now we need four of these things. I have a feeling I'm going to need to take another break here before I finish this part. Oh, geez, what the heck? Okay, so these need to bend out. Let's do those. These straightened out because I bent that one. Go on here. Oh man, not having a good time. There we go. Okay, I don't know where we left off, but I got one of these things on. Got three more. And it's destroying my thumbnails, but so much easier, so screw it. I gotta cut my nails anyway. Heart. Apparently these fold up. Fold down a tab that I didn't do a very good job on. Oh shit. Oh, I fucked that one up. Okay. Let's put this on the correct way. Box goes right here. No, just kidding. There we go. It is once again keyed, so somewhat idiot-proof. But then again, I am a pretty big idiot. Okay.
Getting there.
On the last page here. One of these. Now see, it says to fold this one down, but this one seems like it would be so much easier to twist. That's that. And I just don't understand how this is supposed to go together. But do we just stack them so that there's like two layers or whatever? Or is that just the wrong part that I put in? That was the wrong part. I was supposed to do that part. Well, hopefully that's not critical. In front of me. Okay. I guess for stiffness or something. Okay, I think at this point, if I don't finish this video, I'm not going to finish this video. Just between my SD card filling up and battery dying, and well, I'm hungry. I kind of expected to finish this 3 hours ago. I don't know. The hardest part of this build is waiting for the camera to cool down so I can continue. But otherwise, it's not too bad. Quite fun, actually. I'm afraid I'm gonna have to pick up more of these kits. Or, more likely, just have to dig into the stash that I ordered when I bought the Mars rover. I also bought some Mass Effect chips, if I recall correctly. Alright, so I got that first leg on. I don't know where the video cut out. But it just went right by the little ramp part. It has a ladder, there's the door for the little astronauts to climb down. These tabs are rather difficult to bend without fucking up the, well, anything else. Thank you. One more. And there we go. Bent the shit out of that leg by accident. That's okay. That was pretty fun. I liked it at least. Excuse me while I faff about with those. So, that was a pretty easy build. Not too bad, all things considered. It does come with some extra pieces, namely these little rocket... I forget what they're called. But they're to rotate and adjust the craft so that it lines up properly when in space. Now that's a cool little model. I think it'll go nicely next to my rover here. And I just gotta point out, because I think it's somewhat humorous and I have a sick sense of humor, this model is suffering from the exact same issue that killed the the two rovers that it's based off of. There's dust building up on the solar panels here. But I just thought that was kind of interesting. I did try cleaning it, so there's not nearly as much anymore. But now it's all spotty and gross. So that was a mistake. But anyway, this thing is super cool. I'm super happy I bought it. And that was a lot of fun. Let me know what you guys think. I thought it was pretty cool. Probably get some more. I don't know if I'll film them, though, because this thing... Alright, it is like 6:30 right now, and I started filming this at like 2. And this probably would have taken me like an hour to make if I wasn't trying to film it. So I don't know if I'll film any more of these. Or at least if I do, it won't be in 4K. But, I don't know. Thanks for watching, guys, if you stuck with me this far. And, have an excellent night.